Hey everyone, this is Brian from ActiveMelody.com. I wanted to show you a quick and easy little blues rhythm that you can play. This works on an acoustic or an electric guitar. You play it with a pick and you can transpose it into any key very easily because there's no open strings. Normally I would put together a very proper formal lesson and I do that every Friday, but last Friday I didn't get a chance to do that, and that was because I was launching the new version of the Active Melody website. So if you haven't been to ActiveMelody.com, go check it out. But anyway, I wanted to put out something. I felt weird not having any lessons. So this lesson doesn't have any tablature or jam track, but it is kind of a handy little rhythm that you can use. So let me show you how to play that. It's a nice little blues that you can play. I'm going to show you how to play it in the key of A. Just kind of repeats. It's a 12-bar blues, and as I said, since there's no open strings, you can easily play this in any key. So if you're ever in a jam situation and you want to play a more interesting sounding rhythm, you can use this one. And this is very similar to something you might hear in Muddy Waters' I'm Ready. I think Albert King does a version of that. But anyway, let me show you how to play this. So I'm playing a bar chord here. This is just an A major bar chord. We'll start with that. I'm going to assume you know how to make an A major bar chord. But to get to the seventh chord, the A seventh chord, is you would remove your pinky and put it down here. If we're in the key of A, we put it down here in the eighth fret second string. And you can see that creates a seventh. Now, there's another version of the seventh chord, which is just played without the pinky. So that's how you get that chord. Now, what you do, now that you know how to fret that, let me show you when and when not to introduce your pinky. So your pinky kind of comes and goes. So we're going to strum it like this. We're going to do two downstrokes on the sixth string, or the bass string. Then we're going to play the top string, or the top two strings. You can be a little sloppy with this. Then we're going to go back to the bass string. So we got, and I'm palm muting here. I'm using this part of my hand to get kind of that chunky sound. Now watch this. This time we're going to introduce the pinky. Hear that on the 8th fret 2nd string. So we have, and then I do an upstroke, and I'm playing strings 1 and 2 on that upstroke, but I take my pinky off for that. So when we put it all together, we have. Okay, now what you do, and then you repeat it, so for that repeat part, you do another upstroke, so you kind of do an up, down, and you're only playing those top 1, 2, maybe a 1, 2, and 3 string. There's your pinky again, and then an upstroke, and now you're back in position to play those low strings. It's really fun to do and it's easy. It's the kind of thing you can just sit around and play that for a long time. You can introduce lyrics and all of that as well if you want. Okay, so that's how you play that chord, the one chord. Now if we go to the four chord, in this case it'll be a D7 chord. This is how I'm making it. You know, some of you may know how to make a C7 down in first position. Same chord shape, we're just sliding it up 2 frets. So you're playing the middle 4 strings. Get this nice D7 chord. So your ring finger and your pinky are down on the 5th fret. Ring finger's on the 5th fret, 5th string. Pinky's on the 5th fret, 3rd string. Middle finger's on the 4th fret, 4th string. And your pointer finger's on the 3rd fret, 2nd string. Now to play this, here's how I'm going to call, now that you know the fretting, I'm going to call it the string numbers. So it's 5, 5, 2, 4, 3, 2. So 5, 5, 2, 4, 3, 2. Those are the string numbers. And that's how it sounds. And so you can see here it's got the same melody as the first, as the one chord. And you can see it kind of strummed it a little bit. That's okay. You can be a little bit sloppy with it. And then back to the one. When we go to the five chord, it's an E7 chord, and you play it exactly the same shape as you played the D7. So it's nice because it's right here in the same area as the A chord, the one chord. The other nice thing is this ring finger stays down. Look at the two chords. There's your A, there's your E. A seventh, E seventh. So you got this anchor with this finger here, which makes it easy. So we come here. So again, it's 5-5-2-4-3-2. Now we're sliding down to the D seventh. And then back to the A seventh. And there's your little blues thing. Now, one of the little twists you could do is you could work in some lead stuff as well. If you wanted to improvise, you could go. You know, I'm just kind of making that up, but I'm playing around that A minor pentatonic scale. So think about doing that. That, if you can get to that level, you can really start having fun with this because you can sit and entertain yourself for hours. It's kind of like your little one-man band, you know, you're playing the rhythm and the lead parts. So come up with some creative ways to do that. And we will see you in this Friday. Where are you? There you are. This Friday's lesson. This Friday's lesson, by the way, is going to be awesome. It's another blues acoustic thing. Played with a pick, no accompaniment. I know some of you like those a lot. This is played in the key of G, though. Normally, I do those in the key of E. And somebody pointed out, you're always in the key of E. So I thought, I do a lot of them in E. It's because those open strings. But this one's going to be in the key of G, and it's really cool. So check it out this Friday, the acoustic blues, no accompaniment. All right, we'll see you then.